Hello and welcome. In this video, we will go over some of the basic functionalities and navigation items here in Blackboard for Florida National University. We will also go over some of the basic ways that you can complete assignments and download lecture material in your courses. By default, when you log on to Blackboard, you will appear on this courses page where you will see a list of all of the courses that you are registered for that term. All you need to do to enter a course is simply click on the name and you will enter the course. Here you're going to see that the course is divided into these two sections: details and actions on the left, course content on the right. As a student, there are some very useful things in the details and actions section. For starters, all of your course announcements can be found here under View Archive. And you'll be able to see every announcement for the course, which is a great way of staying organized and following along well. In addition, you also have Blackboard Collaborate here on the left. Blackboard Collaborate is the video conferencing tool that we use here in Florida National University to attend a professor's office hours. All you need to do to open Blackboard Collaborate is click Join Session, followed by Course Room. This will open a new tab on your browser where the session will take place. On the right, as I said before, we have the course content. Here you'll be able to see all of the information on the course. For example, the first thing we have in this course is a Start Here message, Welcome to Blackboard Ultra. By clicking on it, we can see there's more information. Professors might use these to put PowerPoints or Word documents, which you will need for your course. You'll see that Blackboard Ultra is organized into these stacking panes. You can see everything just stacks right on top of one another, and you can simply click the X to exit that document. You'll also see that Blackboard is all organized into these folders: Lecture 1, Lecture 2, Lecture 3. Many of our courses here are organized in weekly folders. So when you click on a folder, for example, you'll see everything you need to do in that folder, or typically in that week. You'll see that assignments always have the due date and time listed underneath it. And doing the assignment is as simple as clicking on it and filling in your answers. Something that is very important as well is some assignments may require you to add an attachment. For example, here's an Educational and Careers Goals paper assignment. By clicking on the name, it opens up this list, this menu on the top right, where you'll see information such as the due date and time, how many attempts you have, and how many points it's worth. To start the assignment, all you need to do is click View Assessment. Here you'll be able to see the prompt, in this case, a 1 or 2 paragraph paper on your educational and career goals. To submit the assignment is very simple. All you need to do is click Add Content, and you'll see this text box appear. For a discussion board or something, you may be able to simply type in your response right here without issue. However, for larger assignments such as PowerPoints and papers, you will need to attach the file. And to do so, all you must do is click on this paperclip icon here, where you'll be able to find the file and upload it for your professor. Once you have it there, you simply need to click Submit, and your professor will be able to grade your assignment. As you can see, Blackboard is very intuitively designed. Everything stacks on one another. It's folders that are very easy to navigate, so you should not have a difficult time navigating your course. But if at any time you do, feel free to reach out to us in the Distance Learning Department. Our email is bbsupport@fnu.edu. We will be happy to help you out. Besides your courses, however, you also have a list of different options here on this menu. Let's begin with the organization page. The organization page has a variety of very useful shortcuts for both students and faculty members. For example, as a student here, you have the Blackboard support link, where when you click on that link, you'll be able to fill out a form that gets emailed to us whenever you need any kind of assistance. You also have the download link for Lockdown Browser, as well as a link to the Learn Research database, which will be invaluable for doing research papers. You have a link to our FNU online bookstore, as well as a link to your student email and student portal accounts. In summary, the organization page is just a collection of shortcuts, which is very convenient and useful for you as students to do your assignments. Below the organization page, you have your profile, which by default will have your name here. When you click on it, you'll be taken to this page. Here as a student, there's a couple of useful things you can choose to do. You can choose to add a display picture over here, so that way when you complete a discussion board or turn in an assignment, your fellow students and your professor will see what you look like. This is optional. In addition, you can also change your password over here, which we highly recommend doing to make sure you have a secure account. And finally, you can adjust global notification settings over here on this section. Here you can adjust how often and what kind of emails you'll get from Blackboard for updates about your courses. Below the profile section, we have the activity stream. The activity stream is a way for you to stay organized in your courses. You can see it's divided by upcoming and recent. And if you have a past due assignment, you'll see a past due section where it'll detail what assignment is past due and in what course. This is a great way to stay organized. For example, here we can see some upcoming assignments in the orientation course that are due June 24th, as well as some upcoming events such as Memorial Day that the university observes. Another way of staying organized is the calendar view. By default, the calendar view is on the day view, but you can easily switch it to the month. And in this calendar view, you'll be able to view your professor's office hours, assignment due dates, and more. As you can see, when I switch over to June, we have Memorial Day here, and we have the due dates for the orientation course assignments. You could choose to use the activity stream, the calendar, or both. They're both great ways to stay organized and on top of your courses. Finally, we have the messages and the results section. Here in messages, you can choose to send messages to fellow students or your professor. And finally, in the results, you can choose to see your grades and feedback on your assignments. Again, if you ever need any kind of assistance with Blackboard, or you're a little confused, or you'd like some help, don't hesitate to reach out to us. Once again, our email is bbsupport@fnu.edu. Thank you.